Now we have Cupid Click coming up right now at this moment, so stay tuned. So this is how it works. Basically, we have Chloe here in the studio, and in the other studio we have three guys who she's going to be firing questions to, and whichever one gives the best answer Chloe likes the most, then maybe she'll get to go on the date with them. So are you ready for this, Chloe?
Yeah.
Can you hear us in the studio, guys?
I can.
Good, good. Right, Chloe, it's over to you. Go for it.
Right, this is a question to all three contestants. What made you apply to be on Cupid Click?
Right, we'll start with number one.
The reason I applied for Cupid Click is that I've been a bit unlucky when it comes to finding someone at the moment, so I'm really to look to get back on my feet, as it were, and it being Valentine's Day and the fact that I was 21 this year, I thought it's time for a bit of change, so I'm going to do something different to try and find someone.
Okay.
Is that alright?
Yeah, that's great.
And for number two?
I came for it because I want to meet someone special, you know? I want to meet someone that I can have a good time with and hopefully treat you nice.
Hopefully treat you nice.
Yeah.
And for number three?
Peer pressure, really. I've been quite unlucky this year. I've had a few relationships which haven't really gone my way. But I thought, why not? Just give it a go, see how it goes.
All right.
All very good answers.
Yeah, very good. Liking the sound of any of them so far, Chloe?
Yeah, they all sound pretty fun.
Especially the one with hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully he's going to treat you right. Do you want to ask another question?
Yeah, this is to contestant number one. I like a guy who can make me laugh. Tell me a funny joke.
Right, number one.
Oh, dear.
on the spot.
Yeah, it's for a comedian, it's a bit hard, isn't it? Alright, what kind of bees produce milk?
I don't know.
Boobies. It's a terrible joke, I must admit, but it is the first one that came to the top of my head.
I think that just fits within the watershed. Boobies, I think that'll be fine. Is that alright then? Is that joke good enough?
Yeah, that joke did make me laugh, I must admit. So do you want to ask another question?
Yeah, go for
it. We'll
do one more.
Okay. And this is contestant number two. Is there anything you can't say no to?
Right, so Mr. Hopefully, number two.
Anything you can't say no to? I can't say no to a good Sunday lunch. Don't know, really. No.
Okay,
no,
then.
And a good Sunday lunch.
Right. Sounds like a good one. Well, we will be asking more questions to the boys later on. Come
To contestant number one, what celebrity do you best resemble and why?
If people saw me, they'd probably think, oh, look, there's James Corden. But
are trying to win this, by the way.
Yeah, just a little. That was pretty funny. I'd probably see myself as probably maybe like a Daniel Radcliffe, but not as skinny, or just, you know, any sort of young male actor these days, you know, they're all good as it is anyway.
So a non-skinny Daniel Radcliffe?
Yeah, pretty much.
Is that alright, Chloe? Like the sound of that?
Yeah, that's alright. Yeah, to contestant number three, if you won a lottery, what would you do with the money?
It might sound quite cheesy, but I'd buy my mum a house, and I'd pay off all the mortgage and everything. I'd give quite a bit to charity, because there's a few that are quite personal to me. And then, I don't know, I might just blow it.
good choice. To contestant number two, if you could have any superpower in the world, what would it be and how would you use it?
I'd want to be able to fly, so I could come over there and pick you up and sweep you off to another galaxy.
That's the
wow. That was a good one on the spot as well.
Yeah, that really was.
Do you want to ask one more question?
No, I'll save my last.
Are you sure? Yeah. Right, okay.
You know what, right? I was going to say invisible, right? And then say I could, like, perm on this.
But we've still got Chloe in the studio, and we still have the guys in the next studio. Are you all right in there?
Yeah,
very good.
Yeah, good. Do you want to go for your next question, then?
Yeah, this is to contestant number two. After a night out, I tend to go to the takeaway. What would you order?
I would probably order a nice sloppy kebab and some nice cheesy chips. Yeah, that's about it. Really.
Great. This is the contestant number one. Describe to me your ideal woman.
Ideal woman number one.
Oh, my ideal woman has to be a great personality, good sense of humour, because I love a girl that laughs. Bit bubbly, bit spontaneous, knows how to have a good time, and yeah, that's pretty much it.
What do you mean by bubbly?
Oh, just, you know, just someone that loves to have a laugh and loves to have fun. I don't like boring girls, you know. They need to be able to know how to have a good time, like on the nights out and that.
I don't like boring girls. Okay, fair
enough. And this is to contestant number three. Pick a song to play on the show now.
We're going to have Flo Rida, Club Can't Handle Me, just because it can't.
That's good.
Fair enough.
Well, what a coincidence this is that we actually have Flo Rida next to play. I think it's meant to be Chloe with this one. So right now we're going to play Flo Rida and then we will come back in a few minutes.
Why should I pick you?
To number one, first of all.
I think you should pick me because I'm a lovely, fun guy. I'm really sweet and I'm really respectful towards women. So if you pick me, I'll make sure that tonight's date will go the way you want it.
Alright, does that sound good?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Number two.
You should pick me because I'm a decent lad. I'll treat you nice. I enjoy a good laugh, so I'm easy to get on with, I'm easy to talk to. I just enjoy it really.
Alright, and finally number three.
You should pick me because I know I wish your girl a good time. We'll have a really good time tonight. And things will go exactly the way you want it.
Right, that's one, two and three. Why you should pick them.
Have you got any in mind that you wanna pick? Any favourite ones?
Not at the minute.
Not at the minute, right, okay. Well, in the next time we will talk to you, we're gonna reveal who she's chosen. So you wanna stick by for that because it's gonna be good.
Right, number one, that's summary now, from what you've been saying, so your cheesy jokes, etc. Go on, over to you.
I think I've done quite well. I try to be as comical as I can with answering questions and that. Most people tell me I'm a generally funny guy and hopefully I'll get picked because, you know, this has been a fun experience and if I don't get picked then I'll do it again sometime soon if it comes up again.
Right, so cheesy jokes, fun guy, number one, and then number two, hopefully he'll treat you well.
well, hopefully, yeah. Also the superhero one, take you off into another world, take you out of this world. That's what I'd do if you picked us tonight for the date. And all around, really, just a neat guy, and I'd treat you right.
So number two is going to treat you right and show you his superpowers. And number three, he knows how to do. He knows how to give a girl a good time.
Yeah, I just think I'll try to be as honest as I can. Hopefully he'll pick me. It's been really good. First time I've been doing anything like this. So hopefully I won't have to do it again.
I don't think many people have had experience on this before. Right, so that's one, two and three. So your decision, hopefully, has been made now in the studio.
Right.
Yeah.
Have you made your decision?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, yeah.
So I'll tell you what, I'll count down from three and then you can just tell us the number, okay?
Okay.
So in three, two, one, which number have you picked?
Number three.
Number three is the winner. Congratulations, number three.
Thank you very much.
We will be meeting in the next link. Chloe will be meeting the love of her life, which is number three. So keep tuned for that. And coming up now, we have...
I didn't expect that at all.
It's good to that music one. That's what it was.
What music one?
The one where pick the song on the radio.
We are on our way now. And you did pick, out of the three contestants, there was number one, there was Frank from Hertfordshire, from Kent, sorry, and there was also Josh from North Wales, but the lucky winner of Cupid Click this morning, 10 till 12, I can hear screams from inside the room. I don't think you get that on general client blind date video on this one. It is Matt. I need some Middlesbrough. Matt, you ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
Alright, here we go. Matt and Paul.
That is definitely a potential couple in the making, and the lovely people at the Star decided to dedicate a bottle of champagne to the couple, so we took them off there to see how they got on.
That
was so funny. That was great. Yeah. Right, I bet he was in the lead at that point.
That is?
I bet he was in the lead at that point.
Yeah.
Like,
it was a little bit, yeah. Because
that joke's got to win anybody over. That's such a good joke.
It was funny, considering like it's on the spot, you know.
I wouldn't have been able to think of anything. Because as soon as the music went on, he was like, all the jokes I've heard in the past few weeks have either been dead baby jokes or racist jokes.
Basically, yeah. me and my friend went like 3 days before, like, went into travel agents. And we're like,
oh,
we've
no
got
way,
these
really?
Weeks, yeah, we've got these 2 weeks off and we've got so much money. We want to go somewhere hot and cheap.
That's class. So, that's really good.
We've got a flight to Bulgaria from Doncaster. The thing is that
give me a flight to the next place, don't care where in the world. Oh yeah, it's Southampton.
Yeah. Yeah, out of England.
Yeah.
You should say that, out of England.
Dublin.
Thank you.
He seemed to be getting on well, so we sent them off for a meal courtesy of Pizza Hut. So we'll leave them to it and catch up with them a little bit later on.